Good morning, everybody, and thank you for the invitation to be here, and thank you for the hospitality. And can I say that today, for the first time ever, I've had gluten-free biscuits. And I'm not sure, Tony, that they're actually what I should be eating.
No, they were for me.
They're healthy. thank you. I suppose, first of all, can I just compliment everybody here in this centre. It is a centre of excellence. I've been here before, and the work that you do is phenomenal. And I want to thank you for what you do. And I want to pay tribute to everybody in this centre and to say that you have our support. And it's a job of hope for us as politicians to ensure that we are advocates for you, your families, and those who work with you here.
And we expect you to be.
And that's why, I suppose, in the last number of years, we've seen an increase in the budget by 31.9%. And I understand a lot of people make the point that we had a decade of cuts and we had a decade of sort of stagnation. But now that we have money as a country, we're able to invest. And as somebody who is immersed in disability section, it is important that we take that point on board. The second point that Kathleen referenced was to pay. Some of you might know that government commissioned Catherine Day to be the convener of a body to look at pay, and we have 50 pilot schemes, 50 organisations with pay being restored in some cases in that regard, both the issue of the cuts in that, which I think is a short-sighted one. Many of us campaigned with Minister Harris and Minister
Cook. On the day that the Cabinet was meeting, especially on the issue of disability, the HSE was writing out to our organisations and leaving our organisations to say that they were cutting the budget by 20 million this year.
So I suppose my final comment would be that the work that's been done in the community and voluntary sector is phenomenal. The work that's been done here is going to be matched, not just by funding, but by action. And the government that I was part of had the First Minister of Disability. We signed the UN Convention,